Celia Marsh had been on a Christmas trip to Bath. Surrounded by her daughters, the mother of five would never make it home after suffering an allergic reaction to a Pret-a-Manger dairy-free wrap that it's thought contained dairy protein. 10 months on from her death, her family say they are raw from the loss and asked a solicitor's firm to speak for them.
She was a much-loved mother, daughter, sister and wife. We miss her greatly and we just want answers into how she died after eating lunch with her family.
15-year-old Natasha Ednan-Laperouse died after suffering a severe reaction to sesame seeds in a Pret-a-Manger baguette. Last month, the coroner at her inquest said their labelling was inadequate. Now the firm faces giving evidence at another inquest.
The pressure on Pret-a-Manger is now more intense than ever. An inquest will ultimately decide, though, how and why Celia Marsh died following a trip here to Bath.
Pret say Celia Marsh's case was down to a supplier mis-selling a product as dairy-free. Koyo UK, the supplier, say this claim is unfounded and are calling on Pret to work together to establish her cause of death. All this publicity has led to others raising questions about their experience with the food retailer. Stuart Semple had a severe reaction to a cup of green tea, which had ingredients in it he was allergic to.
My tongue swelled up, my throat closed up, and I was having an anaphylactic attack in the middle of Waterloo Station at rush hour. So I injected myself with my EpiPen, ate my allergy pills, and my partner and I went back up to try and work out what on earth was in the tea.
Pret-a-Manger have apologised and once again repeated its assertion that it will improve the way they provide allergen information. They have promised full ingredient labelling, which, in the eyes of many, cannot come soon enough. Rupert Evelyn, ITV News, Bath.